Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam ima ba'd. Continuing on in our series of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah's treatise about the signs of the servant's love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we reach a portion where Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned, he said, to love whom he loves, meaning to love who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, al-wala wal-bara, loving for the sake of Allah and hating for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qala Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah ta'ala, the slave gives precedence to that which Allah loves over what he himself loves, both explicitly and secretly. He avoids following his desires as well as those things that cause indolence or indulgence. He is continuously persistent in obedience to Allah, seeking a closeness to him with the nawafil, meaning the extra prayers. The heart is not filled with anything like the love of Allah, coupled with magnification and extolment of him. Those are some of the most excellent gifts that Allah can bestow upon his slave, and this is the bounty of Allah that he gives to whomsoever he pleases. Dhunnun rahimahullah ta'ala was asked about muhabba, meaning the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said, to love what Allah loves and to hate what Allah hates, and to do acts of good for the sake of Allah, and to avoid everything that busies you from the remembrance of Allah, and not to fear in the cause of Allah the criticism of those who find fault. Abu Hussein ibn Malik al-Sufi rahimahullah ta'ala was asked, what are the signs of muhabba, meaning the love of Allah? He said, to abandon what you love for the one you love. Al-Bishr ibn Sirri rahimahullah ta'ala said, it is not from the signs of love, meaning the love of Allah, that you love what your beloved Allah hates. Ruwaym rahimahullah ta'ala says, muhabba, or the true love of Allah, is to agree with the one you love in all situations. Another way in which we show and exhibit our love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is by working diligently to achieve his pleasure. This is according to the statement of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. And he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, the objective of loving Allah is that he is pleased with you. Have you ever seen someone love someone except he strives to obtain his pleasure? These are some of the benefits from Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, and we ask that Allah blesses us to be of those people who he loves and those people who truly love him and exhibit our love for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.